It has been a fascinating time as we have worked closely with and learned from our private preview customers. They are using Security Copilot for the very first time in their security operations. And Security Copilot has been enabling their teams to move at machine speed. This is more important than ever today, when the average cost of a single incident has risen to almost $4.5 million. And globally, the cost of cybercrime is expected to reach nearly $14 trillion by 2028. Our customer feedback has shown that even at this early preview stage, Security Copilot saves analysts up to 40% of the time to complete core tasks like investigations and hunting. Furthermore, for time-consuming tasks like reporting, the savings exceed 60%. More importantly, Copilot is already delivering a range of capabilities and skills to more junior-level analysts that were previously only available to more skilled and seasoned professionals. This effectively means an upskilling of your team to deliver better security outcomes by addressing incidents more quickly and before they can cause harm. To learn more, I am honored today to be joined by one of our Security Copilot customers, Greg Peterson, who is the Senior Director of Security, Technology, and Operations at Avanade. Greg, welcome.
Glad to be here.
To get us started, perhaps you can talk more about your security program, how you have it set up today, and what your overall goals are.
Our security program at Avanade is designed to help protect our people. Our people are consultants, right? We're out there doing work for our clients. And so we're protecting them and the things that they're doing. We leverage as well internally a managed security service with our other parent company, Accenture. And then we have a smaller team that handles the escalations and management there, protecting the 60,000 professionals we have around the globe.
And so you have a very distributed workforce, and they're working from many, many different environments. Does that create any particular challenges for you?
The particular challenge is, you know, the internet is our network.
Okay.
So people are working, again, from wherever they happen to be.
So you're in full zero trust mode, given that the internet is your network. Okay, cool. So Copilot, can you share a little bit of what you learned early on and where you started to see impact initially?
We've started with looking at Copilot, both having our more senior analysts take a look at it, as well as some more junior analysts, including some interns.
Yeah.
So what we found was, for the senior analyst, it could help them with some of the, I'll call it, more advanced things that they needed to do.
Yeah.
Like, you know, what does this obfuscated code do?
Yes.
Or please help write a, you know, KQL query for a particular type of threat hunt.
Yes.
And while our more senior analysts could do that pretty effectively, Security Copilot might give them a new and interesting different way to look at the problem or help solve the problem.
Okay.
But for our more junior analysts that don't have all the context, they don't know all of our security tools, they were able to get up to speed pretty quickly under the tutelage of our more senior folks.
That's wonderful to see that you're getting scale out of people who are new to security. I think it was fascinating to hear that even with this private preview product, your senior analysts were getting good value out of this in terms of it doing, say, natural language to KQL or helping them with PowerShell scripts.
In addition to those, there's a couple of examples where, you know, if you've got a CVE, a new vulnerability that's out there, and you need to go search and find out what is this and does it affect my environment, we're finding that Security Copilot can help curate those answers and give you a relevant summary, the things that you need to know and be aware of.
You know, a lot of people are going to be curious about real security outcomes, things like time to respond or perhaps, you know, identifying those incidents that you just never would have gotten to before. Could you help characterize for us where you saw the gains during the early preview program?
The biggest gains are going to be for the more junior folks that we have on the team, right? The people that don't understand the environment. They don't know, but they know how to speak English. It helps meet them at the language and the skills that they currently do have. We're also looking at how do we help build in the knowledge, right? In the form of prompt books. How do we help teach them how to ask the right questions? And so we found once we've got some of the right questions, you can get some answers that will come back and help save time.
So you're actually creating a reusable store of knowledge in Copilot that's going to serve you and that you'll be able to grow, go forward?
You find that you have to ask your questions in a particular way to get the responses that you want. Yeah. And so with Copilot, as the large language models continue to evolve, we're seeing that evolve as well.
I want to thank you again, Greg, for joining us today. And I really appreciate you. We all appreciate you for being on your AI journey with Microsoft.